Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday, I talked about applying an icon set to a range, and that works great unless you have several columns of data. So here I have four columns of data, and you'll see that when I apply the icon set, so conditional formatting, icon sets, we'll choose one of the icon sets, it appears to me that this red X applies to the 68, and it doesn't. It actually applies to the 66. They always left justify the icon, which just drives me insane. My initial reaction was, oh, we have to center our numbers, and I hate to center the numbers because I like to have everything nicely aligned on the right, so I'm going to undo that. Well, the one thing we can do is there's a setting called indent from the right. So I'm going to use the dialog launcher here in the alignment group, and we're going to use the right indent and then increase the indent maybe up to 3 or 4 in this case. And basically then it's going to take those numbers and move them over from the right side of the cell, but it's still going to keep them aligned as if they're numbers. It's not going to center the numbers, and it gets it actually closer to the icon set. So, you know, an interesting way to kind of achieve the same effect, getting the numbers closer to the icon without moving the icon over. It'd be nice if we could move the icon over closer to the number. Unfortunately, they just don't let us do this, but using the right align and kicking that indent up a little bit allows us to solve the problem very, very easily. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.